The song Fall Apart actually came from a realization that sometimes in my life, I feel God's presence more in the difficult moments. I think when everything is going well, I can tend to forget how much I need Jesus. I forget the fact that I literally rely on Christ for every single breath. But when everything falls apart, when everything goes wrong, I think we're reminded that Jesus really is all that we need. And there's a verse in Psalm 34 that says, God is close to the brokenhearted. And this song really is a confession of that. It's a realization that Jesus truly is all that we need. I want to share these stories with you that illustrate the way that God continues to hold everything together, even when our lives feel like they're falling apart.
On Sunday morning, we woke up to go to church and just peeked out our back window, saw water pooling beyond our backyard, probably a good 50 yards from the house. 10:30, it actually had reached our fence in the backyard. So we decided to pack up, take the girls, and go head up to the Rowlands house. It was around 1:30 or so that we went back to the house. And I was wading in water, you know, up to my knees, and had contemplated trying to get in the door. But the water was up blocking the front door, and at that point I realized that this was a little bit more serious than I had anticipated. Thinking about things like, where do we go from here? What do we do with this? Like, how do we deal with this tomorrow? What, you know, what are we gonna have to do to try to salvage this home? As we're dumping stuff out onto the driveway and into the grass, I can remember honestly calling upon God's presence to help sort of calm the sense of loss. It was at that point we were broken, for sure. I think for me, certainly, I was actually thankful for the flood, for our family, in terms of what it meant for us seeing God work in our lives in a way that we needed to not just say that we depended on God, but to actually live it out.
No one ever gets married thinking they're gonna get divorced, and there I was. I think about, you know, 3 years in, we started to become roommates and not husband and wife. You know, there wasn't a whole lot of passion, there wasn't a whole lot of intimacy. Ultimately, God wasn't alive in our marriage. I just became really, really focused on, I cannot fail at my work because that means I failed as a man. That means I failed as a leader. And in the process of trying to not fail as a leader, I was actually losing the most important thing, you know, in my life. I remember one night shortly after she moved out, I just started bawling. I realized that, you know, I was losing something that some people never get to have, just being totally broken by it. But going through that and getting through it, God's been showing me, like, you're still breathing, you're still alive, that, like, failing in this huge way has not killed you. I think God's grace in our lives sometimes is more shocking than our, you know, our sin or our failures. The fact that I feel like I'm in a much better place. I actually want my life to look more like the fruit of the Spirit. And not because that's what I was supposed to think, that was the Christian thing to do, but really wanting that. God works through the broken things. God is very much in control of all those broken moments in our lives. How many times, how many people do we know where the story is, I went through the worst thing in my life, and that was what changed me. That was what started to turn it around. And I'm just another person that I guess can testify to that.
It's been 3 years since I've been able to put pen to paper about my story. It was nearly 6 o'clock, and I was just getting home from a long day of dreaming when I got the call. I remember wondering what it would be like if I ever received a phone call like this. But I know now I could have never been prepared for those words. My dad had been killed in a car wreck. And even after my older brother and I made it to the scene, it was still too cruel to be true, too quick to believe that it was real, and too surreal to trust what my eyes were telling me was final. Attending my own father's funeral and burying my best friend and mentor, all were things I would have never imagined in my worst nightmares could come true. We each had dreams for the future that included our dad, from fixing cars or first dates, driving lessons, my parents growing old together or my dad walking me down the aisle. All were things that we counted on for certain. But now, 3 years later, I've been carried by the faith, hope, and love of God's people placed all around me. Although I've looked through blurry eyes at the world for some time, I'm finally beginning to see Him and His creation in a brand new way. Although I cannot and probably will never understand the whys, hows, and what ifs involved in this broken path, I do know and arguably know the one in whom life is made whole. Although I'll never be the person that I once was, I can finally move forward in the hope that has been there from before my story began.
Colossians 1 says, He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. All things have been created through Him and for Him. He is before all things, and in Him all things hold together. So I hope that this song is an encouragement of the fact that Christ is holding all things together, even on the days when it feels like everything is falling apart. 'Cause my-